Hey, hi, this is Muhammad Hussein. I'm welcoming you all in my channel, dbadoctor. Today, in this session, we are going to cover how to take a database backup and how to restore in some place using MySQL CMD command. So, in MySQL, we have a different kind of method for restoration. The purpose of restoration is if you want to refresh complete database, and if you want to move a single part of database, and if you want to make a copy of that database in some other secondary server, and we do have to complete database backup and only single database backup, and we also going to see how to take some part of database backup. So if you are new, kindly subscribe and support. We will move on our session. First of all, what you have to identify is where MySQL server is located. With the help of that, you have to connect to MySQL server. So first thing is connecting to MySQL server. Yes. Yeah, I connected MySQL server, and I am going to see what all databases are present here. You can see here there is a complete set of database present. So first thing, I'm going to take a complete set of database backup, that is entire server backup, that I'm going to show you how to do. So I'm going to connect one more command prompt. This is because in MySQL for backup we are using SQL MySQL dump, and for connecting MySQL server we are using MySQL.exe. That we have to keep in mind. So MySQL. MySQL dump, I'm going to connect. Here we have a different method of taking a backup. First is we have to provide a password, and we have to specify, that is all databases, and the location we have to give here. I am just giving some blah blah locations to identify how the backup is happening. I'm going to give this as a backup location. See how we can do. This is the backup location. So MySQL.all on backup.sql. Here we have to provide a password. So once it is come out from that file, that means the backup is completed. Let me see how the backup is generated or not. This is the backup file. I'm going to open it. As it's a SQL, so it is taking a long time because a complete bunch of backup. Here I am open in Notepad. You can see which version of SQL is, and the character strings, end to end backup it is taken. So with the help of this, you just have to copy and paste in your server. Then the complete refreshment is done. This is a simple method of refreshment. And for login moment, we have to do some different way. This is how this is happen here. If you want any particular database to be moved, that is like a current database here, you can see next till the next database, you have to execute the query. Let's say this is the DBM. First step is to create the database. Next one will be using the database and executing the script. You can see here is executing the script. So like that it will MySQL is taken a complete backup. So if you want, you can execute this one or you can use this for future requirement. So we have seen a complete set of database backup that you can open in MySQL bench also. Now we are going to see only one database. Okay, so I'm going to take backup again. But this time I'm going to specify. Let's say I'm going to take a DBA backup. The folder we already taken, I believe. After firing the query, you can see immediately the backup is happened and how the backup is looking at. You can get here complete set of backup details. Okay, so still executing a state. I believe that backup the database is not having any information. So that's the reason it took very fast. Nothing is there, right? Only schema structure is present here. So we are going to use some other database. This time I'm going to use a dbadoctor. Backup is happen. You can see here. That's it. Tables script. It is completely generating the script of creating database table and inserting the record into a table. Like that, complete set of backup. Restoration it is creating. So we have seen a single database backup and a complete set of backup. So let me move ahead and see how to take only some particular table backup. Going to select only one table here that we see. This is because I am not changing the file name. So immediately last backup, if you see last backup and this backup, this backup is only taking employee detail table, okay, inserting record and creating the table and dropping the table. This is only highlighting to employee table. So if you see last one, last session, what it took is it is taken on complete tables backup, employees and other table backup as well. So this time we have, what we have done here, we have removed other table backup and only taken a specific table backup, that is only employee detail, you can see as we have mentioned. So if we want to take a complete backup, table backup, I will show you again how to do this. Okay, this is the complete setup backup. If I open that, here we can get dbadoctor table, dbadoctor test table, employee detail table, tester DBA table. These all are present in that database, that and all are created here. So it's a complete script. So if we want only particular table, that we have seen. But what if employee requested for 2-3 table, that backup only I wanted to restore because that is a slight size and we don't want to test any huge table. We want to, for a testing purpose, this small table is enough. So I'm just taking only 2 table backup, that as per the requirement. That is test DBA and employee detail. Test and employee. So we can see here employee detail, test DBA. Okay, like that we can take a condition based backup. You can give it as a table backup or condition based database backup, that and all we can specify here, and with the help of this we can rename the database. If we want, we have to take a full backup and we have to restore with a different name, and we have to drop existing one. That is the method of renaming the database. So this time we have seen how to take a database backup.